Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to draw the figure using color and charcoal as well as pastels. All right. First, here's my drawing tools that I'll be working with. Today, my standard drawing tool is vine charcoal as well as using black compressed charcoal. Then I also have colored pastels. I have two different kinds. The larger, thicker blocks are made by a company called Alphacolor, and the smaller blocks are made by a company called Prismacolor. All right, the smaller ones are Prismacolor Nupastels. The smaller ones are actually like conte crayons, and that's what I really like to use, why I like to use them. And I also sometimes will use conte crayons like this red conte crayon right here. Also on the table or on this board here is a kneaded eraser, which I sometimes use, and I switch out a lot of times for a Steadtler white eraser. These are very good to white erase charcoal with. Along with this is called an erasing shield made by Alvin. Here we got a Alvin handheld pencil sharpener, a small charcoal pencil, as well as an ebony pencil to work with. Right here's my drawing, or my photo behind me that I'll be working from. So I'll be drawing this photograph right here onto this piece of paper. That'll take about 5 hours to do, so. All right, so let's get started. As I'm looking at this picture, I'm laying out my figure here within the space. So the first drawing that happens is called gesture drawing, all right? So I'm gonna simply gesture out my figure and the pose right here within the space and determine a size to give myself a little bit of head space at the top here. You don't want your figure to run right to the edge of the paper. That's terrible composition. So we'll lay out the head first. I always start with the head when I'm drawing a full figure, just to get a basic head shape down. And I try to work quickly as I'm going through this, because I know I may have to erase it anyway as I'm laying out this figure here and this gesture. I don't like you working from photographs, but most of the time I end up having to. All right, it's hard to get someone to sit and model for you. It takes time out of their day, and in this contemporary world that we live in, we certainly don't have a lot of people that don't have time on their hands, or you have to hire them, which costs money. And a lot of people don't have money these days, particularly artists. But if you're lucky to get a model for yourself, always do with a model, all right? I'm doing this at all without no practice. I haven't loosened up or did any practice sketches to prior to this in a few days. So you can see I'm a little rough at it as I'm laying it out here, this figure. And there we go. That's about the shape and size. And that's how fast it took me to lay out a quick gesture drawing of the figure. I'm not worrying so much about the dimensions yet on the figure. I'll work those out later, but I'm trying to get a gesture down or a pose within the space. And I see that my figure is a little bit too big for this space, so I'm going to have to take it down a notch in size. So at this point, I'll just take it out of there completely. Using the chamois to do that. Chamois, just like a sham wow guy. That's where the sham wow got its name, from this thing, which is called a chamois. It's spelled C-H-A-M-O-I-S. All the O-I-S is silent. Alrighty, so I knocked out my figure. While doing that, I can still see a ghost image coming out back there, which is fine for me. I love to see the work in the paper itself, all right? While I'm doing this, I'm building up a tone in the background. So every time I erase and have to rechange the position or the size of something, I'm building up layers of tone in the background, which are gonna work and only help to make the drawing look more rich in itself. So that's very important when working. All right, so let's start out. I like where the head was up here as far as its top being about right there. I also better put a mark in here for where I want it to end up. All right, so this is another way to start as well. Then, I'm not so sure about its position here. I look over here, I can see a solid center right here that maybe should be in the center, but it all determines on what, how far over this is in the space and how far over this is in the space as well. So if I can capture something, perhaps the width of the head, I can bring it over here and see that's about a width of a head and a little bit more. And right over here, we got a little bit extra. So I'm right about placing it just slightly off to the right of the center of the paper, all right, when I lay the head out. And those are the sort of things you look for as you're doing your work. All right, there we go. Laid out another head here. You have a tendency, it's a bad habit, but we all have a tendency of following our old lines as we're drawing, working our way down through our sketches, all right? You have to avoid that as much as you can. I realize I need to raise this arm a bit. It's a very stiff pose, not the loosest, very stiff and proper. Notice how I'm holding the charcoal too. I'm not holding it like a normal pencil at all. You don't. Charcoal doesn't lend itself to working like pencil does. All right. So you sort of get used to holding it. If you've never worked with charcoal before, you'll find after a little while of working with it, it's a really nice material because you can quickly lay out tonal ranges as well as line just by pushing it sideways. Even you can knock out some sort of tonal shape happening in there. All right, so that's important. Just like that. Alrighty. I think I have my figure down now, and I'm going to speed this video up from here on out, and you're going to simply just watch me draw today. I'll stop at any time I need to let you know about something as I'm working on the drawing. So what you see, what you don't see in other videos is people when they're drawing spending a lot of time looking. It's very important. Not just looking while you're drawing, but to actually step back and see
what you have here, all right, overall, because right away I think this is fairly correct as far as proportion in this area, and this is sort of correct right in here, but right in here we have an elongation happening where this is just too long right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have to rearrange and change this up and bring it up a bit, all right? Things that I was doing while I was drawing, by the way, was the first step, after you do the gesture drawing, you want to start looking for proportions like that. And what I did was I started, since I started with my head, I used my head as a measurement, all right? It's sort of a visual cue almost as a measurement from the top to the bottom of the head. You could also do the same thing with the side of the head. If you think it's the head that you got right, correct the first time you drew it, you can use that as your measurement system, all right? So you saw me mark off the photo even, measuring out how many head spaces there are from here, to there, and then down to there, and finding out, and then even putting little marks on the photo itself to figure out if I'm getting it in proportion correctly. Now overall, I got the general height of it in proportion, but what's happening here is it's elongated right in the center there, so I do want to lift that up. Be willing to make changes to your drawing. The best people that, the best artists that create are ones that are willing to freely just make changes when necessary, all right? There's no secret to it. It's just simply they step back from the drawing and they can see their mistakes, and instead of ignoring those mistakes and carrying on to a finished drawing that's incorrectly proportioned, they will go back and correct those mistakes in the drawing. Other things I was looking as I was working out the drawing are different anomalies in the drawing, things that are similarities, like for example, this line here almost crosses straight with that line, so I'm looking for that and I'm trying to sort of make that happen throughout the drawing. There's a crossover right there. Another thing is too, getting angles. All right, you can use this your stick of charcoal, or if it's not too big, you could use a pencil, is what we consider a sighting stick, and lay out an angle on here. So in order to get this to be the correct angle right here on the shoulder, I'll actually rest it along with the charcoal there to make sure that it's correct. Just like this, carrying it over here, doing the same thing here with this angle right there, this angle, which is very different, this angle here, I did it, as well as this one up here, all right? So that's another important thing to work out while you're drawing, is those angles. And you can see I'm throwing in tone with the side of the charcoal as I'm building up, all right? There's some shadow under the cloth here. Now I could be getting dangerously, because at some point I'm gonna have to suggest shift to color, all right? I don't wanna lay out too much black, to get too much charcoal on the paper, because if I do, my colors may turn out a bit muddy, all right? So be aware of that as you're drawing, and make the corrections as you see that the corrections need to happen. All right, so that's what I'm going to do at this point. I'm going to shift this and bring this up a little bit.
In London.
at this point, I'm going to want to switch it up with some color. I'm not making you don't want to necessarily finish it out in black and white if you are going to add color. And if I keep going with this, with black charcoal, I'll run the danger of making it very muddy. All right. So one thing you want to do is you want to clean out some areas before you add the color in, because it will make it muddy. Notice the eraser itself. The eraser gets very dirty with charcoal. So one way to clean it is actually to take it off of a rough surface. This surface of this wall happens to be rough enough, so you just sort of erase it off of that. And you'll see it cleans back to a white again. Very easy, very quickly. See, I can make a chisel shape out of the eraser eventually, a little fine point, then I'm able to erase certain areas. Your eraser should be thought of like a drawing tool, all right? So think about, you'll see that I've applied some charcoal and I pulled back and taken some charcoal out of certain areas, again, using the eraser. It's just like a brush, in a sense, a paintbrush, you know, paints light colors only. But that's the way it works. So yeah, so anyway, that's another tip with it. Another thing I was thinking about mentioning while I was working on this drawing is another benefit to using vine charcoal or charcoal in general is you can use the side of the stick. Anytime you need to make a straight line, you just simply drag it along the side of the edge of the stick instead of actually drawing it from the point end. So a lot of times you see me doing this, even with my left hand, my non-dominant hand, I can use charcoal and drag that line out straight. And that way I get really nice, sharp, straight, clean lines. All right, this time I'm going to continue. When I start with my colors, I'm not going to think of my color as color in itself. I'm going to think about three different tones, all right? Black or dark, mid-tone, and light, all right? And so when I choose my color, I look at the same sort of aspects about it. I'm going to choose a range of greens, not just one green, but a few to get what I'm looking for. Here we got a nice green compressed charcoal. Here's a lighter green, and this is that sort of a lemon lime green that I'm looking for, all right, that's got a bit more lemon in it, some yellow. So and then I'll go even as far as pushing a bit of yellows on there. All right, so here's my range of tones, something like this being my range for the shirt, the aoyai, and the pants she's wearing. And also I may want to warm up the face a little bit, so I may use something that's sort of a natural, sort of a lighter color for that. Here's a sort of a skin tone color. It's not too much of a transition from that green to that yellow to that skin tone, all right? So they're almost within the same color palette. And that's the sort of thing you want to think about while you're choosing your color. Also, some reds, by the way. Excuse me. I want to grab some reds that will work along with this green. So I want to have a complementary sort of a complementary red to the particular green I'm working with. And that would probably be about this one. How do you know what colors go together really well? Well, when you take the pastels themselves and put them up next to each other, you'll figure out what ones look good together. There's no secret to color, working with color and color choices. It's really your preferences, all right? Look at that green with that that reddish orange, all right? They almost look like they're meant to be together. At least that's my own personal preference, all right? So here's my general color direction that I wanna go with, something that's sort of this complementary red and green sort of idea, all right, for the drawing. Notice I haven't worried about the background. I'm not really concerned with the background. I may leave the background blank in the actual drawing. There's all this worked area to the background that's already sort of building up an interesting surface to it. I'm not sure what I want to do with that yet, so I'll keep deciding while I keep drawing. All right, as you see the drawing progressing right now, I'm switching off to a new material as well. I have this. This is a charcoal pencil, all right? It's a 2B hardness, which is sort of on the hard side. Sometimes as you tighten up your drawing and you're working details into it, you're going to need something to get into small little spaces like this. I either like to use this, or I also like to use this Prismacolor ebony pencil. Now the ebony pencil itself is graphite, it's not charcoal, so that'll make a difference. This will give me a solid but lighter line that's more attuned to my mine charcoal. The charcoal pencil will actually give me a nice black. All right, so this is what you want to use to sharpen it with. This is a handheld pencil sharpener. It's made by Alvin, that company. It's just this little simple aluminum sharpener with two holes in it, all right? The first hole, the smaller hole, is for standard pencils. The larger hole, which makes a fatter conical shape, is for ebony pencils, charcoal pencils, as well as colored pencils, all right? Anything that has a soft lead that can break easily, you want to sharpen it with a large hole in the pencil sharpener. Just a note, like that. And it'll give you a sharper point with a conical, a more fatter conical edge to it. Okay, so I'm gonna continue working on this. And you'll see that this is a new material that I added into the mix. Also, when I get into working with tight detail, I'm going to be using my erasing shield and my eraser along with the eraser, because some of those little particular places I may need to erase to clean out, the only way you can get it is by getting in detail. So you use this sort of like a stencil, like I said before, to be able to cut in there and pull out some real details. All right.
So na sha ni sha.
That's it for this this drawing. I think it's finished. I'm going to sit with it for a while, probably till tomorrow, so look at it again with a new fresh light, and then I'll determine for sure that it's finished. But overall, I'm quite happy with how the results turned out with this drawing. I kept the face fresh. You saw how I went through there with all the details of the shadows and the subtleties going through the dress, but I never went back to the face because I was very happy with that looseness. You want to keep a sort of a freshness about it. My worries are if I were to go back in there and really delve into some details and shadows in there, it may look overworked. You never want your drawings to look overworked, all right? So I left it at that, leaving it with a nice open background to it. Notice there's nothing in the background at all, except for all the eraser marks that I made. All the changes and adjustments that I made to the drawing are still there. And that's what's beautiful about it. It's like it keeps it fresh in a sense. I'm happy with it. That's it.